got the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
One important person during the 1940s was A.A. McMillan. They even had a day celebrating him called A.A. McMillan Day in 1949. A.A. McMillan was the fire chief for a long time in Grayslake. One person even said he was everything, and even he thought he was a big deal. He led Grayslake through the Depression and through World War II as well. He was the mayor from 1927 to 1941.
Beautiful thing, as long as I hold.
Douglas Getchell was a World War I veteran. He was the commander of the American Legion of Grayslake. Lots of Legionnaires came one day from all around the state and celebrated his life on Douglas Getchell Day on July 18th, 1948. The parade was held on Lake Street. The speech took place in what is now the Grayslake Apartments on Lake Street.
And he picked me out because I was from Grayslake and he lived in Grayslake. And I got to dance with the commander.
Is that
The lead-off dance for the party at Girls' State, for the evening party.
I got the world on a string.
Fort Hill School was a one-room schoolhouse located on Town Line Road, which is now present-day Residence House. Back then, it merged with Grayslake School District 45 in 1948 because it didn't have enough population to support a school all by itself. It's because it drew from majority farmland area. It was located in Madrona Village.
There were many World War II veterans from Grayslake. Jack Richardson fought in a European theater. He was even a prisoner of war in Germany. He went out to war 1 week after he graduated. He graduated June 6th, and then he was drafted on June 12th. As he aged in life, he was still angry with people with German descent.
Bill Mogg was drafted into the army 10 months before the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor. He ran a mess hall for 5 different companies where he was only given 39 to 41 cents per day per person that they were feeding. During one of his post-war interviews, he mentioned that at one time he'd seen thousands of airplanes in the sky at once. Also, he was right outside of Paris when it was liberated from German control.
There was also rationing in Grayslake. The Girl Scouts collected scrap metal, and there was a memorial created for the Lake County veterans.
Well, we knew it was serious. And as, well, Pearl Harbor, we were in sixth grade.
Did anything happen in the school there?
We began to read the Chicago Tribune every morning. That's the way school opened up. What had happened in the war. We'd get the maps out to point to the spots that had happened.
And this is in grade school?
This was sixth grade.
Wow.
1941. We did that in 7th grade, we did that in 8th grade, because it was very important that we pay attention to what was going on.
Chicago, Chicago, that's my hometown.
The Grayslake High School District 127 was established in 1938. But it wasn't until 1941, however, where District 127 hired an architect to construct Grayslake Community High School. The building plans were made despite the many citizens who voted down the creation of the high school, and the buses were purchased in 1943. In January 1946, construction began on GCHS. On September 9th, 1946, 200 students of Grayslake assembled in the grade school auditorium to hear the announcement that the high school is nearing completion. Finally, in December of 1946, GCHS was complete. The first graduating class was in June of 1947.
I went to Libertyville for 2 years. We were all tuition students.
What's that mean?
That we had a high school district, but we had no building. And they used their tax dollars to pay for us to go someplace else.
So you didn't have to pay the tuition, the community did?
It came from our District 127 existed.
But there was no high school?
There was no building. Well, we were overjoyed to have our own school.
What were the school dances like?
Fun.
Fun?
Everybody went. There wasn't anything else to do. We had always traveled as a clump. I think my class, when we were in eighth grade, we probably had 28 students. Mm-hmm. And the class that graduated in 1948 was 35.
And all 28 of you would just...
Not all, but most of that group, we started first grade together. I don't know that we thought we had free time, but we were always doing things. When you've got a handful of friends, always, you're always busy. Just being together.